In 7th standard, you learnt about scattering of light. Can you recall what activity we did to understand scattering of light? We passed white light through the milky water. At the edges, there was bluish tinge. That helped us to know why the sky looks blue. We looked at the formation of shadows and understood how eclipse takes place. Imagine that you are in a pitch dark room. You are in front of the mirror. Can you see yourself in the mirror? No. You need some light in the room. Light rays travel from source to your body. Let us select this one ray to understand how we see an image. Some rays are absorbed while some rays are bounced back by your body. These rays, which are bounced back, hit the mirror. Mirror by its nature bounces back these rays again. These rays, which are bounced by mirror, reach our eyes. Our visual sensors process this information and we see our image in the mirror. But do you also see your image when you stand in front of the wall? No. Why mirror is so special? It happens with still water as well. You can see reflections of trees in the pond. What will happen if I throw a stone in water? Will the image of tree be the same? No, it will be hazy and disturbed. It will also behave the same way if it is windy. As long as water's surface is steady, light is reflected in an orderly way and there is a clear image. But if water is disturbed by the wind or any movement in water, light is reflected in many directions. It was not until the 11th century that the Arab scientist Al-Hazen came up with the law that describes exactly what happens when the ray of light strikes the surface and bounces off it. If a ray of light could be observed approaching and reflecting from a flat mirror, then the behavior of the light as it reflects would follow a predictable behavior known as the law of reflection. I will project this light on the mirror. It comes back in this direction. This projected light is called as an incident ray. The light which bounces back from the mirror is called as reflected ray. Draw perpendicular at a point where incident ray and the reflected ray meet. This is called a normal line. This normal line divides the angle between the incident ray and the reflected ray into two equal angles. The angle between the incident ray and the normal is known as angle of incidence. The angle between the reflected ray and the normal is known as angle of reflection. These two angles are labeled with the Greek letter theta accompanied by subscript. Read it as theta I for angle of incidence and theta R for angle of reflection. The law of reflection states that when a ray of light reflects from a surface, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. We can see that the reflected ray and the incident ray are on the opposite sides of the normal and are in the same horizontal plane. When an object is viewed in a mirror, eyes take in rays that have been reflected. But the brain assumes that light rays have reached the eyes in a straight line. The brain works backward along the light paths and perceives an image behind the mirror. This virtual image does not exist. Activity. With the help of graph paper, laser light, protractor and glass mirror, verify the law of reflection. Consider at least 5 different angles for incident ray. Are your observations in line with the prediction? Will there be any difference if thick glass mirror is used instead of thin glass mirror or acrylic mirror? You can use cell phone flashlight as a source of light if laser is not available. Challenge. Blue shaded regions are obstacles in the room. How many mirrors are required to direct light from entrance area to exit area? First, draw a diagram of the proposed solution and verify it with mirrors.